Good afternoon to one and all. I am Preeti Kiran, and my topic is cyber parenting, need to create boundaries. Now, in today's era, internet access has been very common and practically universal in all the households with the school-age students. And internet is being a fantastic social and educational tool with the full of potential threats as well. Due to easy availability of internet, children, it is necessary to make a proper surveillance on their kids, which is a part of cyber parenting. Now, what is actually cyber parenting? Cyber parenting is referred to as proficiency in digital literacy and digital citizenship, demonstrating the proper parenting style in digital culture. Now, there are many types of parenting styles, which depends on the person, which depends on parent to parent, how they communicate with their child. But mainly these are divided into three types, that are enablers, limiters, and mentors. Enablers are those parents who give the easy access to their children for the internet, and they don't keep an eye, or they don't keep a limit on what to do and what website or what app to use and what to avoid. The next comes are the limiters. They are the totally opposite of enablers, that they can limit the use of internet, and they limit, they always keep a close eye on what their children are doing on the internet. And they always set up some rules and some guidelines or some screen time to prevent their children from any kind of mishappenings which could happen with them. Then comes the mentors. These are the somewhere between the enablers and limiters. They don't give the easy access like enablers, and they don't limit like the limiters. They keep a balance between usage of internet to their children, that how much could be used and what could actually be done on the internet. Now, when a youngster use the internet, they go through various digital threats, which could include cyber bullying, cyber grooming, or risk of gaming. Now, cyber bullying is the harassment or threatening of a child on any social media app or over the internet. There was a case study in which a 15-year-old guy was bullied over the Facebook app in the comment section or in the instant messenger apps, where he was called by various names by his peers, and he was also bullied physically in order to shut his mouth and not to tell whatever was done to him on the Facebook app. So in that scenario, his teacher saw this, and when he went to talk to that age group who was bullying that student, they just denied that they were taking it as an innocent joke, and that is not to hurt someone. But when we started through the statistics of cyberbullying, we found that almost 50% people thinks that cyberbullying won't create any kind of psychological trauma on this student, whereas approximately 20 to 30% people think that, yeah, it can create a psychological trauma on the student. Here I have presented a worldwide metrics which shows the average of online bullying between India and international level. Next threat which is very common is cyber grooming, in which an adult person assumes or presumes himself to be a known person of a youngster and tries to contact with them for the purpose of any kind of relationship or for any friendship purpose, and they later consider themselves as a known person for them, and this comes under cyber grooming. So there was a case for this as well. There was a girl of approximately 18 years of age who contacted a man of who showed his age of approximately 20 years on online apps. But later on, when she met him, she found out that he was much older than him. But before meeting, they already had a friendship with each other, which led to a strong bond between them. But without knowing that the girl was being used by that man, she went according to him, and at the end, the man just used him and cut off his ties from her, which lead to many psychological consequences in her life, which were kind of difficult for her to come out of. Then the most common threat nowadays is the risk of gaming. As we all know that online gamings are the most common and the most important aspect in children's life nowadays, because some play an online game just for just to pass their time or for recreational purposes, while some just play it on a regular basis as a habit, and they just keep on playing for the entire day, avoiding other things which could be helpful for them. Now, there in the risk of gaming, there was a game which was introduced in 2016 that was known as Blue Whale game, in which there was a series of tasks assigned to the people who were playing this, in which they had to psychologically and mentally or physically torture themselves, and which led to the ultimatum as the suicide. And this blue game was mainly played by the youngsters or the teenagers who were there at the time, who were there in their teenage group, and the game was also named as the suicide game because the last level of the game, which was concerning the suicide of the person who was actually playing that game. In this, there is also a game which is popular nowadays, that is PUBG, in which has led to the violence and the aggressive nature of children, and which even led to the fight between parents and children because of intervening of parents to stop them from playing such kind of games. Now, it's very difficult for nowadays for children to for parents to teach their children what exactly is correct for them and what is not. But even in this digital era, it is very necessary to always keep an eye on the children by playing, by telling them what could be done and what could not be done. Because there, except for only these threats, there are many other threats which could be posed on the children. That may include threats due to virus attacks or threats due to any visiting of any inappropriate sites. So they can. So it's very important to just keep an eye and surveillance on children, and they can just simply create some guidelines or rules for the screen time and maintain a relationship in which the children feel free to share anything with them. With this, I just come to a complete conclusion that the most important issue that is to be ensured that children understand the positive, negative and ugly aspects of the online world. The most crucial thing for parents is to keep an eye on their children's personal devices, but it's not easy. They can simply hide and neglect the safety guidelines because the devices are under kids' control. So they have to just keep a relationship which is in which the children could easily tell them or encourage them for device-free dinners, family time or physical activities that can keep them distracted from the mobile phones. It would be easier in this way to share their feelings and their emotions with parents easily. Thank you.